we're going to go ahead and try to gain access to Jeff's inbox again. Click OK. And what do you know? Here's Jeff's inbox right here. You can see up here the emails to Jeff Bezos. But yes, I could eavesdrop or essentially read all the CEO email that I want. But what's more interesting for the fraudster is to be able to send email on behalf of Jeff to anybody in the world. So let's go ahead and do that. We're going to click on new email. And here you can see the mailroom here that the email is going to be initiated from, but we'll go ahead and change that in a moment. And we're going to put accounting at KPMG. Subject is please change our wiring instructions as follows. And we're just going to copy this over. Whoops. Input in here. Dear KPMG. Paste this. Thought I'd copy this. Let's do it again. And we're going to change the routing number, new routing number, 3222-71627, new account number, 094-227-1836. Thank you, Jeff Bezos, of course, CEO. And now you could see if I sent this email, it would come from, it would initiate from the mailroom. But since we now have permissions because we've been delegated access from Jeff's account to the mailroom account, I could change that to Jeff. Voila. And now I go ahead and click send. And let's go over to the KPMG account. And there it is. So here we have an email from Jeff Bezos. Here, Jeff Bezos at hackmyemail.com and to our fake KPMG account. So this is how a fraudster could leverage a technical vulnerability in exchange to hijack an email account and then leverage that email account to do a social engineering attack to commit fraud and to potentially steal millions and millions of dollars.